So hey, it's the Bassin Guy. Today we're going to talk about weedless spoons. I'm going to show you some secrets that you've probably not seen before. I'm going to talk about rigging weedless spoons. So let's dive into it. So the traditional way of rigging Johnson spoons was usually to take some kind of trailer and thread it one way or another onto the hooks. And this works. It worked for years. There's nothing wrong with that. The main thing is different trailers are used for different things. A thin trailer like this I tend to use for more of a slower, like slow rolling type of a technique. Whereas when you use flat trailers that plane the bait, this rig here I used before the days of the horny toads and different type of weedless frog baits. This is what we used to use. You know, we use different flat twin tail type trailers that planed the bait off. You bring them over the surface, and again, they work great. But I'm going to show you some different ways to rig trailers up on weedless spoons. And a lot of it revolves around the use of a screw lock. So instead of putting the trailers right on the hook and taking up hook space, what I've done in some cases is drill a hole at the back end of the spoon and then thread my screw lock through that hole. And then once that screw lock is on the bait, I can put any kind of trailer I want on there. I can put a swimming grub type of a trailer. I can put a flat frog kind of a trailer. I can even put a willow leaf little blade on there. That will actually spin behind the bait. It looks pretty cool in the water. I actually caught a fish on this morning. It's just got two willows on split rings on the spoon, and this actually caught a fish kind of in open water. I think it might have been a fish schooling, roaming around on the flat. So that works. Caught a fish on this morning as well. It's a again, I put a split ring through the little hole I drilled. I have a swivel and a typical fluke rig, you know, with a swim bait hook with screw lock, and it works. Following this presentation, there's going to be a little video, and all the fish caught on that video were caught on this. You can see it's kind of missing some of its tails because I got some short strikes and stuff. But this tricked out spoon actually has a rattle shrink wrapped to the weed guard. I don't know if you can pick up the rattle, but that works. And this also gives off some sound and extra flash. And then here's a black spoon with a yellow trailer. You're only limited by your imagination with what you can do with these spoons. They can be fished from winter through summer. You can slow roll them. You can fish them on the surface. The main thing is to just try. These are great fish catching baits. Yep, they may be somewhat old school. I know, redfish guys still use them, and in salt water, the saltwater guys tend not to use the type of trailer situations that us bass guys do. But even something like this with a little willow leaf blade on the back probably be great for redfish. So let's hop out on the lake and I'll show you how I was catching some fish on the spoon just the other day. Well, as you can see, weedless spoons work. They're, after all these years, they're one of those baits that, in my opinion, should never go out of style. And you shouldn't hesitate to try them, especially in places where fish see a lot of spinner baits and chatter baits. Give them something different. So always switch up. But old is new again. Give it a try. This is the Bassin' Guy. Subscribe if you like. And we'll see you out there on the water.